Welcome to a lesson on tangent planes. The goal of this video is to determine the equation of a tangent plane to a surface. Let's start by viewing a tangent plane to a surface. Here, this yellow plane is tangent to the surface at the purple point. Let's animate this so you get a better feel for this tangent plane. Again, this yellow plane is tangent to the surface at the purple point. So the goal of our lesson is to determine the equation of this tangent plane at a given point. I'd like to start by reminding us how we found the equation of a plane when we had a normal vector. Remember, we use the components of the normal vector to help us determine the equation of the plane. And we use a similar idea when it comes to the equation of a tangent plane. Let's take a look at how we're going to do this. But first, instead of defining a surface explicitly as z equals f of x, y, we can also define a surface implicitly by big f of x, y, z equal to 0. And we're going to have to do this to determine the equation of the tangent plane. So if big F is differentiable at the point x sub 0, y sub 0, z sub 0, then we can determine the equation of a tangent plane to the surface expressed implicitly by the following formula. The first thing I want you to notice about this equation for the tangent plane is that it does involve the first order partial derivatives of big F here with respect to x, here with respect to y, and here with respect to z. And then notice we're multiplying these partial derivatives by x minus x sub 0, y minus y sub 0, and z minus z sub 0. And the sum of these products is equal to 0. Now I will prove this formula in another video, but the idea behind the proof is that because the gradient of big F is going to be normal to the tangent plane at the given point, it must be orthogonal to every vector in the tangent plane. So the idea here is that if we take the dot product of the gradient of big F and vector V in the tangent plane, it will always equal 0. And this dot product is what gives us the equation of this tangent plane. Let's go and take a look at a couple of examples. We want to determine the equation of the tangent plane to the surface at the given point. So the first thing we need to do is write an equation for big F of x, y, z. And that's going to be equal to x cubed minus 3xy plus y cubed, and we'd have minus z equals 0. So we're moving this z over to the other side and setting it equal to big F of xyz. For the next step, we're going to go ahead and determine these partial derivatives, and then we'll evaluate them at the point 1, 2, 3. So the partial derivative with respect to x is going to be 3x squared. This will be minus 3y, this would be 0, and this would be 0. The partial with respect to y would be 0, negative 3x, plus 3y squared, this would be 0. And the partial with respect to z is going to be 0, 0, 0, and then negative 1. And now we need to evaluate these partials at the point 1, 2, 3. When x is 1, we'll have 3 times 1, that'll be 3, minus when y is 2, we're going to have minus 6. This will give us negative 3. Now the partial with respect to y at the point 1, 2, 3, well, x is 1, so this would be negative 3. Y is 2, so we'll have 4 times 3, that's plus 12, so this will be 9. And the partial with respect to z will remain negative 1. This is all we need in order to determine the equation of the tangent plane. So all of this is equal to negative 3, so we'll have negative 3 times x minus x sub 0. Well, x sub 0 would be 1, plus 9 times y minus 2, minus 1 times z minus 3. Must equal 0. So again, we have our partial derivatives here, here, and here, evaluated at the point 1, 2, 3. We're multiplying it by x minus x sub 0, y minus y sub 0, and z minus z sub 0. Now we'll distribute, and that'll give us the equation of the tangent plane. Negative 3x plus 3 plus 9y minus 18 minus z plus 3 equals 0. So we'll have negative 3x plus 9y minus z equals, left side we have 3 minus 18 plus 3, that's going to be negative 12. Move to the other side, that'll be positive 12. And a lot of times textbooks like to have the leading coefficient positive, so we could multiply through by negative 1. That would give us 3x minus 9y plus z equals negative 12. Of course, it's the same equation in a different form. Let's take a look at this graphically. So in gray, we have our surface. In red is our point of tangency. In yellow is the tangent plane. And I also plotted the gradient to show that the gradient is normal or orthogonal to that tangent plane. Let's take a look at one more example. Here's our surface. We want to determine the equation of the tangent plane at the given point. So first, big F of x, y, z is equal to x squared plus y squared to the 1/2 minus z. Let's go ahead and determine our partial derivatives. The partial derivative with respect to x is going to be 1/2 times x squared plus y squared to the negative 1/2 times 2x. The derivative of z would be 0. Let's go ahead and clean this up. The 2's simplify out. So we have the partial with respect to x would be x all over the square root of x squared plus y squared. Now the partial with respect to y is going to be 1/2 x squared plus y squared to the negative 1/2 times 2y. Again, this simplifies in a similar way. So we have y over the square root of x squared plus y squared. And the partial with respect to z is just going to be negative 1. Now we'll evaluate these at the point negative 3, 4, 5. So our numerator is going to be negative 3. And our denominator, we're going to have the square root of negative 3 squared plus 4 squared. That's going to give us a square root of 25, which is equal to 5. Partial with respect to y at the given point. Our denominator is going to be the same. Our numerator is now going to be y, so we have 4/5 for y. And the partial with respect to z stays negative 1. Now we have all the information we need to determine this equation. We're going to have negative 3/5 times x minus negative 3, that'll become x plus 3, plus 4/5 times y minus 4 minus 1 times z minus 5. And again, this must equal 0. Now I probably want to clear these fractions out of here, so we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by 5. That'll give us negative 3 times x plus 3 plus 4 times y minus 4 minus 5 times z minus 5 equals 0. Let's go ahead and take this on to the next slide and finish it up. So we'll go ahead and distribute. We'll have negative 3x minus 9 plus 4y minus 16 minus 5z plus 25 equals 0. So we have negative 3x plus 4y minus 5z. Let's look at our constant terms now. We have negative 9 minus 16. That's negative 25 plus 25. That's actually going to be 0. And again, if we wanted to, we could rewrite this as a positive leading coefficient. We'd have 3x minus 4y plus 5z equals 0. Let's go ahead and verify our answer graphically. In gray, we have our surface. In red is the point of tangency. And in yellow, we have our tangent plane. So it looks good. And once again, I went ahead and graphed the gradient vector so we could see that it is orthogonal to that tangent plane. I hope you found these two examples helpful. Thank you for watching.